This is going to be as simple as I can make it. The BRP Go app, once you've downloaded, you touch the particular vehicle that you're going to be using it on. In this case, the Can-Am Spyder. There are instructions on how to even connect the phone and the headset. You don't need to turn the key to start the bike. You just need to turn the key on. And you wait for these symbols right here to disappear. They're right there. Push the mode button to get that to go away, and you wait for those to disappear. It can take 20 to 30 seconds. By the time I've got my gloves on and got going, it's gone. And then you push the joystick in, because it says if you're pairing the phone and headset, you need to do this first. So this is the joystick right here. And as you push it in, the menu changes. You can push it down to music and to settings. Push it down over and up to Bluetooth. And you can either push the joystick in or to the right. And then you go to your phone's Bluetooth and it will see the BRP Connect. You touch it. You see the number, you click pair, you click the joystick to the right, and the connection is good. Same thing when you're doing a helmet. You add a helmet, you put the headset into phone pairing mode, and then you go through the system and it pairs. You do not want to have the headset paired to the phone as well as to the bike. You pair the headset only to the bike. And if you want contacts in your phone system, you click allow. And so now when you exit out by pushing the joystick to the left, you push the joystick in and you go up, because normally you would see that. This is your gas, your trip A, your trip B, and your total. When you want to clear them, you push the joystick down and hold it. If you want to see the trip A or B over on the left, you push the joystick up and hold it. If you want to see total miles over on the left, you push the joystick up and hold it, and now you get total miles on the left. Push the joystick in, and now you go up to phone. This is all without using the app on the phone. You do not need to use BRP Go when you're making a phone call. Now, I don't have my helmet headset on, but if I did, I'd see contacts or history, and I can go through and select the number to call. It has nothing to do with BRP Go. So basically now I'm going to go back out. I'm going to put my phone. I hold it in a holder on top of the glove box because the glove box is very hot. Open the app, and I need to back out of this. Don't need it anymore, because now you just need the app. You plug it in to the special USB, either in the glove box, depending on the bike, and it connects. You hit a button on the back, and when I do, it brings up the connect in here. And here you have a few Apps available: Genius Maps, which is GPS, Sygic GPS, Rever is a tracking mapping app. It's, you can use it to track, you can use it for GPS. This last weekend, I think there's been some updates and it's not working real well. For navigation, it requires cell service to download map data. Genius or Sygic, you download the map data to the phone ahead of time. Sygic is free, but if you want voice commands and other features, it's like, I think, less than $20 a year. Dash Radio is free. It gets you all kinds of music. Now, in order to choose it, I push the joystick in. But if I push the joystick in and hold it, it backs me out. You've got Phobo, which is a tire pressure monitoring system. You can have your bike, you can have your trailer, you can have all your other vehicles. You can select the one you want to check, and you can see the tire pressure. You push in the joystick in and hold it, it backs you out. Eat Sleep Ride is similar to Rever, but I'm finding not many use it, and it somehow doesn't track the miles right, and that's an app problem. Cardo requires you have the headset paired directly to the phone for it to work. The problem is if your headset is paired to the phone as well as to the bike, it causes Bluetooth confusion. So if you go to listen to music and a phone call comes in, you talk, you hang up, the next thing you know, the headset's paired to the phone, which wasn't playing music. So then you have hiccups. So basically, the headset should only be paired to the bike. But that's, you push the button on the back, and you bring it back to the main menu. When you've got music playing on the phone, I can push the joystick up. No helmet is connected. So I've got music playing. Now it's in the... I can push a button and switch it to speakers. Whatever music you want to listen to, whether it's the Apple Music with downloaded music, or whether it's music from SiriusXM, Google, YouTube, whatever, as long as it is active on the phone, which means that you, let's see, I opened Dash Radio up, but let's see, where's my music? There's my music. As long as it's in that situation, whether it's playing or not, when you turn the bike on, it will continue to play. You just hit the joystick as the system boots up. You have to have the BRP Go app open. They fixed this when we had BRP Connect so that you didn't have to have it open, and I'm hoping they'll revert back to the way we had it. But currently, when you start the bike up, the BRP Go app needs to be open and on top. And as soon as it loads, whatever music you are playing, you just hit the joystick up and it'll just start playing. Once you see those symbols right there, you're good. And I hit the joystick up and it just starts playing whatever music I was playing. And since I'm not connected, my phone is not connected, you don't need to have it connected if you're just gonna ride it around town or something. But if you want to use the GPS, to use Phobo, then you can open it up and choose what apps you want to open. Sajik is, for me, it was like almost $18 for a year subscription. Genius has a one-time fee of like $75. I haven't looked or checked lately. But you download map data and you can...
Traffic delay on your route has changed to 45 minutes.
Zoom out, zoom in. You can be doing this while you're riding. You use it often enough. You learn and understand where that highlighted green box is. You can stop the route if you want to. And I can do this when I'm riding. Push the joystick in and hold. And you've got Genius Maps. And you can see the top left, the search. Because I'm stopped, it will want a keyboard if you want to type something in. But I choose, when I'm looking for a gas station and I'm on a ride, I can do this when I'm moving. And it'll locate the closest gas stations to me, and I can just choose one. I tend to like Chevron. And it will take me to the local gas station. It will erase or stop the other route you were using, so that after you get gas, you want to activate the route you were on, so that it'll continue. But since I'm indoors in my garage, the GPS isn't getting a signal too well. But